Now, if you guys haven't heard about this one, where have you been? Do you live under a rock? Okay, gotta pick it up. Gosh, we're already at 13 and a half minutes, and there's still more. Hey guys, it's Nikki, and today I have a little something different for you. I thought, you know what, it's been a while since I've done a recent book haul, so I'm going to do that. Now, there's a lot of books here, so I'm not necessarily going to what each of them is about, because then this video is going to be like 4 hours long, and we don't want that. This is quite a massive book haul, and you know, this isn't even all the books I've received recently, but I'm not going to go digging through my shelves for books that I've, you know, recently reviewed or books that I've also picked up that I've already read, because it would take quite a while. And the chances are is I've already talked about them on my channel before doing individual reviews for them. So then it just gets a little repetitive for you guys. So I'm going to try here and there, maybe not always, but to share my recent book hauls as I go, and we'll see how that goes. I may not share everything that comes through book mail to me, but I will do my best to throw these in, because I don't know about you guys, but these are like my favorite YouTube videos or BookTube videos to watch, because I love seeing what everyone's getting, what's out there that I haven't heard of, what I want to pick up, and of course it makes that never-ending list that's slowly taking over the world that much bigger. So let's just jump right into things. The first book I have for you is Kill River 3 by Cameron Robeek. You guys know how much I love Cameron's work. You know how much I love this trilogy or anything he does. So I can't wait to get to this. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to read it as of yet, as I have quite a few review reads on the go, but hopefully soon. We recently came across these books and didn't even know they existed. And so of course the hunt was on to try to find all three. So here they are. You guys may have heard of them. Maybe you guys know about this trilogy. If not, maybe I'm introducing you to something exciting. So we have Shadow Moon, and this is by George Lucas and Chris Claremont. This is book one. Then we have Shadow Dawn by Chris Claremont and George Lucas. And then we have Shadow Star by Chris Claremont and George Lucas. These three books are a series based on, to my knowledge, and don't hold me to it, is based on the setting after Willow. If you guys ever watched the movie Willow, so of course, very, very exciting. But of course, if you're going to read these three, and it is a setting that goes with that storyline, you have to read Willow, right? So of course we have Willow by Waylon Drew. So I'm very excited. So the plan is eventually, when I get to it, no review reads or anything, I'm going to jump into Willow and then I'm going to go on with that trilogy. I'm very excited for this. I love the movie Willow, and let me know if you guys know Willow and if you love it just as much as I do. The next one I have here is The Rise of the Chemist. This is book two in the Granville series by Nathan Parker. I cannot wait. I loved book one. I haven't read book two yet, but Nathan was so kind to send it to me. He signed it and everything as a thank you, because Nathan was one of like the first, at the time, indie authors that I ever reviewed for when I was jumping into the book community. So I've known him for like two plus years, and I'm just in awe of how successful he is and his writing and everything about him. So I was very excited when I received this in book mail. The next thing I have on the list is Term 1 of the Ashcroft Academy. This is book 1, 2, and 3 in the Ashcroft Academy series. This is by K.M. Sharon. You guys might also know her as Kelly Sharon. I have, however, read book one, which was Wild Magic. I read it last October for a readathon that I was co-hosting with Julie from Hungry Bookworm and, of course, Clint from Reads Readers. We did the I Put a Spell on You readathon, and I haven't read book two or three yet. So, of course, I had to go and get my hands on this. So now I have the first three. So I can go on with book two and three when I am ready for it. Very excited for this. The next one I have here is Broken Hearts, and this is the next story in the Fright Vision series. Can't wait to jump into this. Now, Fright Vision, you don't need to read these in order. We have been, since Logan and I have started getting into the series, so we've been reading them in order. We can't wait to read this. I picked this up shortly after release, and it is the first one that we own that's got the new like color gradient theme for the covers, so we're very excited for this. Can't wait. Very excited for this. The next three I'm gonna show together, because why not? They go hand in hand, and I've been hearing so much about these. Again, I had to pick these up. I picked them up a while ago as they were releasing, and I still haven't got to them. Oh man, you guys, so much reading, so little time. We have the Magpie Coffin. I'm sure you guys have heard about these. These are just going around the book community like crazy, especially in the horror community. And these are splatter and western, so I'm very excited for them. Next one we have is Hunger on the Chisholm Trail. And then we have Dust. And the covers for all these are just fantastic, you guys. Then I have Buried with the Night by Sion Das. This was kindly sent to me by the author himself. Again, can't wait to get to it. I do have it on my review reads list. So as soon as I've got to it, I will share it all with you guys. Okay, the next one I have is Gates of Fire. This is an epic novel of the Battle of Thermopylae. I've heard that battle pronounced a few different ways, actually, so I'm not sure which way is correct. Even when I've looked up the pronunciation of it, I get multiple different versions. I'm just gonna call it Thermopylae, which is what I've heard the most. This is by Stephen Pressfield. I picked this book up because kind of a trickle-down trail. I recently, if you guys know, read Wildcat Book 1 in the Caledon Saga by J.P. Harker. And there was one particular battle scene in that that reminded me a lot of 300 movie. Recently, I watched the 300 movie, and then it really got me interested in learning more about that particular battle between Spartans and the Persians. Now, this is nonfiction, so it may be, of course, like a more intense, not necessarily like historical type read, but I'm very excited for it. And if I enjoy this, then maybe I will be interested to actually look up true history books and maybe get some more actual facts about this particular battle. But I'm very excited for this one. It's got fantastic reviews and a fantastic rating, so I hope it is as good as I'm hoping it to be. The next one I have is Somewhere in the Dark by R.J. Jacobs. Now, I honestly don't know too much about this book. I have read through the synopsis a couple times, but I've kind of like tried to like forget about it so that I go into it with the unknown, because I love that. The very funny, exciting story is R.J. Jacobs was the first author that I ever reviewed for HarperCollins Canada. This was very kindly sent to me from R.J. himself. I cannot believe I own a copy. I can't wait to read it. And of course, I do have it on my list that when I can get to it, after I get through all my review reads, that I will review this for you guys as well. So I'm very excited, and this cover is amazing. Then I have What You Don't Know by Mary Jones. Recently had Mary Jones on my author spotlight, and she so kindly sent this to me. As a thank you gift, and I can't wait to get to this one, and I'm so excited to have a copy to have in my collection. If you guys don't know what this is about, you can hop over to that video and watch the author spotlight with Mary Jones, and she does talk a bit about it and give you more insight on what it's about. Then I have Take What You Can by Heather Garvin. If you guys don't know, I recently did an author spotlight as well as a full review on my blog and here on my channel of Take What You Can, so you can go and check that out. Love this cover. Of course, I loved it so much, I had to go out and buy myself a physical copy when it released. The next one I have here is Until Summer Comes Around. I have heard so much about this one. It is buzzing around the community, especially the horror community. And of course, I had to go and pick it up. But what really gave me the push was Cameron Chaney's review of this book. It just really gave me all the feels, and I thought, you know what, I already had it on my list, but now it's like one of those I have to go and purchase it now. So I went and picked it up. The next one I have is Devil's Creek by Todd Keesley. Now, if you guys haven't heard about this one, where have you been? Do you live under a rock? This book is circling around in the community like crazy, horror community, book community in general. It is just getting flying, incredible reviews from everyone. I can't wait to read it. Funny thing is I purchased this copy because of all of the reviews that were going around, and I'm super excited to get into it. But I actually recently reached out to Silver Shamrock Publishing, who is the publisher for this book, and asked them if they were looking for reviewers, because I see that the content they're putting out is fantastic, and I would love to be able to read as much of it as I possibly can. They actually sent me over 12 different e-copies, which I have on my lovely Kobo reader, which I haven't got to those yet. I have started reviewing some of the work that has been coming my way though, and one of the books they sent me was this one, which is fantastic because I can read the e-copy that I received and keep this in pristine condition. So you will be seeing, as I'm catching up on my review reads, you will be seeing a lot of books through Silver Shamrock Publishing, because they are just killing it. Everything they're releasing has just raving reviews, and I'm so super excited to be reviewing for them. Okay, I gotta pick it up. Gosh, we're already at 13 and a half minutes, and there's still more. The next one I have is Monster by Duncan Swan. This is volume one. This was so kindly sent to me from the author. He sent me two copies. Not quite sure what I'm gonna do with the second copy yet, so we'll have to see. This one's gorgeous. It's got the black sprayed edges, and I can't wait to read it. Not gonna give you any insight of what it's about, because I do plan to start reading this next week, and it is part of my September reads, because it comes out in September, you guys. So I'm going to read it and review it for you, so you're going to hear all of what it's about and my thoughts on it very soon. The next one I have is When the Sky Goes Dark by Oliver C. Seneca. Again, Oliver took part in my author spotlight. So if you'd like to hear more what the story is about or get to know Oliver directly, you can check out that video. This one I'm very excited to get through as well. I also have this one on my September plans, so hopefully I will have full reviews out soon. So again, I'm not going to tell you too much of what it's about. The next one I have is Curse of the Pigman by Asher Ellis. This again was so kindly sent to me from Silver Shamrock Publishing, one of the review reads they sent my way in physical copy. Super excited for this one. Again, raving reviews, and I have this on my TBR for my review reads very, very soon. So again, I'm not going to give you too much information on what it's about, because I will be giving you my full review, full thoughts very soon. The next one I came across just randomly searching, and I can't find too much information about this author. I can only find a Facebook page, which is very odd. So I don't know if this book was an indie author's book or self-published or what have you. It does have a publisher's name on there, but I know a lot of times the authors could have some type of company name, that sort of thing. I'm not sure. Don't hold me to this, but I'm wondering if it is from an indie author, which you guys know I adore. But it is called Dinosaur, and this is book one in the New World series. So I'm very excited for this one. Again, it's a chunker, and it's by Stephen Lelouwin. I don't want to even try to pronounce that, because I feel like I'm going to completely butcher it, which you just did, Nikki. Very excited for this one. I was searching for more dinosaur reads. I really enjoy Jurassic Park. I really need to go on with that series, because I haven't even read book two, and I need to read more from Michael as well, because he's also got dragon teeth. But of course, while I was searching, I came across this, and I had to get my hands on it. It's got raving reviews, a really high rating on Goodreads, and everyone just seems to love it that picks it up. And I believe book two and three are already out as well. So that's kind of a great thing, because you go through it, you love it, you want to pick up the next one, it's already ready, it's already out. So I'm excited for this one. I picked up My Best Friend's Exorcism. This is by Grady Hendrix. A lot of you guys are talking about Grady Hendrix and his work. He's out there like crazy right now, but this one really intrigued me. I want to read all of them, but this is where I want to start for Grady's work. And the cover's in fact just fantastic. It's got that old VHS style box. I can't wait to get to this. I've heard raving reviews. The next one was so kindly sent to me from the author himself, and that is Don't Smell the Flowers, They Want to Steal Your Bones by Duncan P. Bradshaw. Again, you guys know how much I love Duncan P. Bradshaw. Absolutely adore him. His writing is fantastic. It's gory. It's hilarious. It is full of life. So I cannot wait to get to this one. This is soon up on my review reads, so you'll be hearing more about it very soon. Then I have Wolf Moon by David Irons. I picked this one up right when I knew it was released. Cannot wait to get to it. I've heard awesome reviews. John from Books of Blood gave it a fantastic raving review, and he did such an awesome job that of course it made me want to read it that much more. Again, it's very soon up on my list for review reads, so you'll be hearing more about it very soon. Then the next one was so kindly sent to me from David Irons. This is Polybus by David Irons. Again, I hope I'm pronouncing it right. Again, I've heard so many different pronunciations for the title. So, and again, this has that old nostalgic feels for the cover. This is on like an old Atari case, like video game case. Or the video game cartridge, and I love it. I cannot wait to read it. It's gonna have to be high up there on my review reads. Can't wait to get to it. The whole thought, like the whole process, the covers. This guy's got to be like the king of covers, because every single one I see, I'm just like in awe of. The next one I have here is Leaping Wolf by J.P. Harker. This is book two in the Caledon saga. Again, you guys know how much I loved Wildcat, so I can't wait to get to this one, and the covers are fantastic. These chunker stories, but they just devour you. you. Okay, almost to the end. The next one I have is Psych by Matt Green. Matt Green followed me on Instagram. That's how I found him, and I saw the cover and I was automatically drawn in. I don't know who could be drawn in by this cover. And then I went and read the synopsis, and this is like a psychological thriller, but it sounds like it really skims across that horror vibes. This is about your main character, who's actually a nurse at a psychiatric unit, who slowly starts losing his own mind. So he starts to see things, you know, shadows, things around him, hearing things, and he's starting to wonder if the things that are happening around him are real, or if it's really his own brain attacking him and he's truly, truly losing his mind. So this one really intrigued me. You guys know I love nonfiction when it comes to learning about brains. One of my favorite books of all time is Unthinkable, which is about the 9 most extraordinary brains in the world, which is nonfiction. So I also love fiction stories that go around that brain, because the brain is truly a powerful tool, but it can really attack us and you never know what it's going to do to us. So I'm very excited for this one, and the cover is fantastic. And the last one I have for you was a random pickup. I was out and about at my favorite bookstore and I picked up The Walking Dead Typhoon by Wesley Chu. I'm very excited for this one. I love all things Walking Dead. I love all things zombies. They will always be very close to my heart. I know a lot of people say zombies are dying in the world and it's all about, you know, like vampires or that sort of thing, but I really love zombies and any type of like apocalyptic or post-apocalyptic type story or anything like that. So I'm very excited for this one. So of course I read all things The Walking Dead and all things zombies that I can get my hands on. So when I saw this, I had to have this, and it will be one of those books I'll pick up when I have time for it, of course. There you have it, everyone. That is some of my recent book mail, I guess. Both things that I've picked up over the last 6 months or have been kindly sent to me by the authors, whether it's for review reads or thank yous or what have you. Fingers crossed that I can get through a lot of my review reads. I go back to work finally after all this COVID stuff here, and schools are opening and daycares are going to be opening to full capacity. So I will be going back to work. So, and my reviewing list is still extremely extensive, so that's going to pull back some of my reading time. So we'll see. Things might slow down a bit. But anyways, a little something different. It's a long video already, so I should just stop rambling. And yeah, if you've picked up any of these, you've read them, let me know. No spoilers in the comments, though. Have any of these piqued your interest? Are you interested in picking any of them up? Let me know. Maybe we can plan a buddy read or something. That would be freaking awesome. Okay, that's it. I will see you guys all in my next bookish video. Bye.